I'm Abdullah here from the channel Chad's Encyclopedia. So today I'll be teaching you how to get glowing effect in cycles. So first we have to backtrack a little. This is Blender 2.91.2, and so it's a 3D modeling software, and it has two rendering engines. The first one is Eevee. Now Eevee is the real-time renderer, so it is basically just speed over quality. And then you have Cycles. Cycles is a photorealistic renderer, but it is slow. And so if you want to preview your render, you use Eevee. The thing is, Eevee has this really cool feature called Bloom. I'm going to show you how it works by going into the Shading tab. And as you can see, the material is already ready. And to go down and set the emission color to the brightest setting. And then we have to increase the emission strength to whatever we want. So I don't know, maybe, 2.3, whatever. And then you can set it to any color you want. For this example, I'm going to set it to red. If you go into this camera icon here, that's actually render properties. And if you tick bloom, you get this glowing effect. And if you go into render view by clicking this thing, that's how you get the bloom effect. And to increase this, all you have to do is increase the emission strength and you'll get more light. So there's this little problem. Eevee, as I told you, it's speed over quality. So if you have a scene where it needs to be photorealistic, you cannot use Eevee, because Eevee is the rendering engine with the bloom effect. So here I'll show you. If I switch into cycles, there's a small problem. See, there's no glow. So to get the glow, all you have to do is as I showed you, we have to set the settings as before. It has to be set to the brightest setting, the emission color, and you can set the emission strength to whatever you want. I'm going to increase the emission strength right now just for fun. And then you have to render this. You could do that by going to render and clicking render image, or you could just press F12 function and F12. And it will render. Now, since this is cycles, it's gonna take some time. It's about to finish, and yes, it's finished. So what you do is you close this render and go into the compositing tab. And this isn't the best place to work with nodes. So to close this menu over here, all we have to do is press N. And to get rid of this timeline, we have to do this. And you have to tick the box that says use nodes. So if you want, we have to make the image this image appear in the background. By background, I mean all these tiles thing. So we have to click on add and search for viewer node. There you go. And you have to connect this to this. Blender has this really cool feature where if you drop another node in between this line, this connection, it just automatically connects it for you. So I'm just gonna search for glare. And there you go. If I just drop this on, you see that it does glow, but it's not the same as Eevee. For that, all we have to do is click on this streaks thing over here on the glare node and click on fog glow. Now the max setting is 9, so the max glow setting. So that is the downside to using cycles instead of Eevee. You can't just infinitely keep expanding the strength of the emission. But you know, cycles is a photorealistic render. If you need glow, this is how you do it. And to save this image, all you have to do is you have to click on here and you have to go into the viewer node thing, and then it will show you the image that is glowing. So we have to click on image to save it, and save, and all we have to, so that's how you get the glowing effect in cycles. Thank you very much for watching. If you like the video, please subscribe and like it and share this video so someone else can watch it too.